We saw in the previous video how IFL statement helps us to take the decisions and apply the appropriate interest rate for a given duration. If you start exploring open source projects, you will find many such examples which make use of IFL statement to implement the desired functionality. JavaScript also offers an alternative to achieve the similar results, switch statement. Now, switch statements are ideally recommended when you have too many conditions to compare. Here is an example. I will create a new file called as switchcase.js, and in this file we are going to implement a simple functionality. Now, based upon the car type, we are going to determine the price of that particular car. So if you just look at this particular table, we have three different car types: a hatchback, a sedan, and a sport. For hatchback, the price is $25,000. For sedan, it is $40,000. For sport, it is $50,000. Let's just implement it in the Visual Studio Code. So I'm into Visual Studio Code and I created a file called as switch_case.js. Now, to implement our requirement, let's start with the definition of our car type variable. So I'm going to create a constant, car type is equal to, I'm going to assign a value as hatchback. Let me just format it and I will save this file. Now, if you remember the table, we have three different car types. For hatchback, the value is 25k. Now, we are going to determine the value of car based upon the car type. So, instead of using if else, this time I am going to make use of switch case statement. So, let me show you how it can be done. So, switch, inside that I am going to pass car type, and the body of switch case is enclosed by the curly brackets. The next statement is case, wherein you need to put the value that needs to be compared. So in our case, the first value is going to be hatchback. We need to add a break statement, followed by another case statement, which is going to compare the value of car type to sedan. And finally, we need to compare it with sports. So if it is of type sport, then in that case, there is going to be a different value. What I'll do is that instead of just putting it a blank line, I'm going to add a console.log statement. So console.log, inside that I'm going to add a single quote and I will print some user friendly message. So price for the hatchback is, let's just put a value over there. So I'm going to print a value as 25,000. I will just copy this statement. I will put it into sedan. I will copy the same statement and put it into sport. And I will change the values out here. Now, instead of hard coding the car type inside the console.log, I can also make use of backtick operator and replace it with the actual variable. For the timing, let's just leave it as is. Maybe we'll refactor it and we'll see how it looks like. So almost, yes, the code is almost done. I'll just execute it using the terminal. So I'll type node and then I'll say switch_case.js. Let me press enter and you will see that it is actually printing a correct value. If I'll change the value of hatchback to, let's say, sport, and I'll save it, I'll re-execute the code. Yes, it is printing $50,000. So the beauty of this switch case statement is that it actually improves the code readability. What I also noticed is that on the different forum, people saying that if there is substantial number of comparisons to be done, switch case performs better than if else. They also equally claim that if the number of conditions are low, it is better to make use of if else and not the switch case statement. Now, this reminds me of another interesting operator available in JavaScript, the ternary operator. Now, ternary operators are useful to represent simple if-else statement. For example, if a car is running below 60 km per hour, then we could call it as it is running within the limits, or it is running very fast or above the speed limit. Let's see how we can implement it. So I created a file called as ternaryoperator.js, in this we are going to define a variable called as car speed. I'll assign a value as 65 to it. Okay, let me declare it as constant because we are not going to change it. Let's maintain the better practice. And then I'm going to create another variable called as message to driver. And this time the message will be derived using the ternary operator. So first we need to put the condition. So car speed, if it is greater than 60, then in that case we are going to say that it is above the speed limit. So this is the truth value, above speed limit. Otherwise it is within limit. If you just notice the syntax, the condition is put first, then we have a question mark, then we have the truth value followed by a colon, and then finally we have a false value. I will just print the message on the console. So console.log message to driver. I will save the file, and if I try to execute it using the node command ternary_operator.js, and see that since the value is 65, it is definitely above the actual limit, and hence it is printing a message as above speed limit. Now if I have to code the similar syntax using if else, you will see that the number of lines will be more. So let me just type the actual if else implementation. Let's create a dummy variable called as message, assign a single quote value, it's an empty string that we are going to assign, and if I just write the if condition, it is going to be if car speed is greater than 60. That's the first condition. Inside this we are going to initialize the message variable. You will see that it is above speed limit. Else it is within limit. So again, message is equal to within limit. Looks good. So you'll see that the similar implementation using the ternary operator was just written in one single line, while in case of if we had to use more than 3-4 lines. So definitely ternary operator looks more concise. So based upon this particular experience, we can draw a conclusion saying that the ternary operator is actually useful wherein you have scope to inline the if condition. Also, another interesting thing about ternary operator is that it is the only operator which accepts three operands. The first condition part, car speed is greater than 60. Second, the truth value, which is in this case is above speed limit, and the third is within limit, which is a false value. So these are the three operands which are accepted by the ternary operator, and there is no other operator which is doing that. Now based on all of these exercises, you must have realized that there are various options available in JavaScript when it comes to coding the conditions. Now each of these approaches that we discussed has its own unique appeal. One may be good for the readability, another may be good for the performance. Feel free to explore these features and let me know if you are facing any problems. Thank you.